say, can you see, by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
You may be seated. Fun Country Night. Glad to be here. All right. Well, we have a twofold purpose in being here tonight. And one of them is to celebrate our country and declare that we have a wonderful heritage. It seems like there is a lot of discouragement in the nation today and a lot of things we see that we don't like. But we want to focus on what we do like tonight. We got a great country. It's the land of the free, home of the brave. Amen? All right. We're so glad to have everyone here tonight. We have a lot of people in uniform, people who serve in uniform, whether they're dressed for it tonight or not. But we appreciate everyone who has served, and we'll take some time here in a little bit to honor them. But we are glad you're here. And in a few moments, we'll be telling you more about that. But we do have a few, just one rule, really. And that is, if you're in the grandstand, no sparklers. Because we've had someone ask, a few people ask tonight, no sparklers in the grandstand, because that's a wooden building and you could come down. And this is our last year at the Putnam County Fair in this present iteration, because a lot of things, the grandstand is going to be redone, and the merchant building, the 4-H building, is going to be torn down. We're going to have a new exhibition hall. It's going to be beautiful to see for next year. But for this year, we're glad to be here one more time in the present state of things, and we appreciate everyone and all the help that we have been given. And for each of you coming out tonight, and we'll be taking a few moments here. And Pastor Ben, where are you, Pastor Ben? Here we go. Our charity of choice this year is the Heartbeat Center out of Lima, and we also have a branch of that in Putnam County as well, in Ottawa here, because the whole idea of the sanctity of life is a dear thing to our hearts. And so I've asked Pastor Ben just to take a moment. We have buckets set up. They say Heartbeat on them, and that's where the money will go this year for charity. The fireworks are a gift from our church family to you guys, to our Putnam County community in Northwest Ohio. I know there's folks here who aren't from Putnam County. But the money that's given tonight will not go for fireworks. It will go to the Heartbeat Center, every dime of it. So, Pastor Ben.
All right. Well, thank you, Pastor Coates. And what an evening. It is a privilege to be here and just tell you guys a little bit about Heartbeat of Lima and Heartbeat of Putnam County. They are one organization. As Pastor Coates said, my name is Ben Anderson, and I am the Vice President of Heartbeat. And you may have seen our table out there. There's a little bit more information about that. But we are so grateful for Ottawa. We're so grateful for Putnam County because you guys are amazing supporters of our organization. And without you guys, we would not be able to serve these families, serve these young ladies in the way that we do. So thank you so much. You might be asking, well, what is Heartbeat? No, it's not a vein center. We don't prescribe blood pressure pills or medication. We are a pregnancy resource center. So what that means is many young ladies and families will come through our doors afraid, confused, frustrated. They find themselves in the situation of being pregnant, and we offer free pregnancy testing. We offer free ultrasounds. We do counseling. We do parenting classes. We provide material aid. We even provide adoption assistance. So if somebody wants to adopt their baby, we'll help connect them with attorneys and lawyers that can help them consider that as an option. But there's so many things that go on at our Heartbeat office. And the location right here in Ottawa, in case you're like, well, we didn't even know Ottawa had a Heartbeat office. We do, and it is on East 3rd Street. So open several days a week, and we look at expanding that here in the next year or so. But thank you guys so much for your support of Heartbeat of Lima. Without you guys, we could not do what we do. So here is how you can continue to help us. One, pray for us. We need prayer. We are on the front lines of evil, of wickedness, of people considering abortion, and we're walking people through choosing life. So pray for our team, pray for our volunteers, pray for our leadership and our organization. And we can always, second thing is, we can always use donations. So if you've never donated to Heartbeat of Lima, you can come find us at the table out there or go to our website. You can just Google Heartbeat of Lima and Putnam County. You can find out information. Then the last way that you can help us, on August 8th and in November, there are two very important elections coming up. August 8th is about issue one. What that means is raising the threshold to amend the Ohio Constitution to 60%. What Planned Parenthood has been doing over the last few years is going into different states and trying to put abortion and legalizing that in the state constitutions. And so that's very important. And if you're confused about that issue, look it up, dive in. Then also, November is a very important election as well. But your pastor here at Faith Baptist Church, he can provide you a lot of information about that as well. So pray for us. You know, get involved, ask questions. We're just here to serve these communities. So thank you so much for being here tonight. We appreciate your support tremendously and could not do it without you guys. Thank you.
Red, white, and blue are its colors, colors of thrilling The song God Bless America was written by Irving Berlin in 1918, and it became popular in 1938 when Kate Smith frequently sang it. Berlin was quoted as saying, "It's not a patriotic song, but an expression of gratitude for what this country has done for its citizens." He wanted to create something to celebrate America as a special place to live. We have certainly enjoyed freedoms like no other nation, and that is due to the sacrifices of the brave men and women in the armed services that we honor tonight. So let's celebrate America together. I'll sing the song through the first time, then feel free to join in as we raise our voices together, asking that God bless America once again.
Tonight to all of our first responders. How many first responders do we have here tonight, either active duty or no longer serving, but you have in the past? First responders, can you stand? Can you stand? Let us recognize you. I see some up here. Fire, police, EMS. Fire, police, and EMS. We're especially thankful for our fire department. We couldn't do what we're doing tonight without our fire department. They're keeping us safe back here, getting ready for the fireworks, which will start in half an hour or so. And for the guys, all those that serve in the as emergency medical responders, EMTs, EMS, paramedics, I had the privilege of doing that for a number of years. I know it's a sacrifice, and we appreciate these folks who are doing it. And for the men and women in the police services, those in the, we say in the blue, of course they don't all wear blue, but one of them is very special tonight. We have Denny Cupp here tonight. Denny, former police chief from Lipsick, and it's his birthday tomorrow, so shouldn't we sing happy birthday to him? He said something about this tonight. He wanted to hear it, so we should sing for him. Now, I don't think he really thought I would do this, okay. But he wasn't really asking for us all to, but I think we should, don't you? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Denny. Happy birthday to you.
And many more.
How many years in law enforcement, Denny? I can't see that. 45 years in law enforcement. All right, thank you, Denny. And we have our sheriff from Putnam County with us tonight. Sheriff Seifger, you're back there somewhere. I saw you. There you are waving. He's over by the shed at the end of the grandstand. Thank you, Sheriff Seifger. And we also have two of Ottawa's finest here tonight, Shane Vance and Brian Lomelee. And see these guys in blue, be sure and tell them thank you.